My brothers and sisters, today we remember and honor the lives of 8 honorable souls. Those souls were someone's mother, someone's father, someone's grandmother, someone's grandfather, someone's son or daughter, someone's sibling, friend, or neighbor. In 2001, I lost my brother-in-law to gun violence. He was killed at his family's business. My family lived through the hardship that we are living today. We had to rely on our faith to find strength, patience, and hope. Today I'm here to tell you that we all mourn with you. We see you. We hear you. We feel your pain, and we stand with you. I learned in my Islamic faith that glad tidings will be given to those who patiently endure, who say when they are afflicted with calamity, to God we belong, and to Him we return. And I also learned in my faith that whoever takes a life, a single life, unjustly is as if taking the lives of all humans. And whomever protects a single life as if he protected everyone's life. As a state senator, as a proud immigrant who came to the United States as an immigrant myself, I will not only share my thoughts and prayers, which are extremely helpful and needed, but I'm going to hold myself and all elected officials at all levels, city, state, and federal, to do everything in their capacity, in addition to thoughts and prayers, to truly protect our communities so that this never happens again. Thoughts and prayers are helpful and needed, but we must reform our laws. We must invest in mental health. We must pass common sense gun legislation. We must fight to ensure that our society, our community, our country is a place of love, compassion, where every human is loved, is welcomed, and they feel that they belong and they're not treated as a second-class citizen. We must live in a society where each member of our society is at the decision-making table. We must ensure that when we see injustice, we stand up together, we rise together to protect the most vulnerable in our communities. Dr. King once said in his opposition to the war in Vietnam, when many soldiers were killed in the name of freeing other nations at the time when we were struggling and suffering here in the United States, he delivered a very powerful speech and said, "I reserve the deepest place in hell for those who remain silent at a time of a great moral crisis." Let me say it again. Dr. King quoted Dante in saying, I reserve the deepest place in hell for those who remain silent at a time of a great moral crisis. This is the time to act. I pray to God to grant the families of our beloved ones who we lost the patience and the strength to heal. The patience and the strength to celebrate the life, legacy, and beautiful memories of these 8 souls. I pray to God to light the path for all of the families of the victims, for our community and our nation. I pray to God that His love enfolds all of us and our families during these difficult times. As an American, as a proud American citizen, as a proud immigrant, and as a proud Muslim, I tell all my Sikh brothers and sisters, I got your back. You are my brothers and sisters, and I will do everything in my capacity that you're honored, you're dignified, you're protected, and you are at the table as equal citizen, as equal participant in this great nation. May God bless you, may God bless your families, and may God bless our country.